The 2018-2019 school year marked the beginning of Driven, the School of Innovation at Mills University Studies High School. Through Driven, we seek to give students opportunities to master their learning and skills and to accelerate through learning, making our students powerful entities for the economic future of Arkansas. This is our journey.
Why did you decide to roll in the Driven program? Because of the opportunities it gives me to work ahead and finish school faster.
I decided to enroll in the Driven program because I thought it was a great opportunity for me, academically speaking.
The reason why I decided to enroll in the Driven program is because I have better opportunities in there to work at my own pace.
How is it that you became an inaugural teacher for Driven?
Well, last year I taught literacy here at Mills High School. And when I was interviewing for an English position, they asked if I would be willing to try something new. They needed an English teacher, so I said, yeah, let's give it a try.
So 2.5 years ago, Mr. Clayton asked me if I wanted to join him to go to Salt Lake City to check out a school that's been doing a program like this for about 5 years. And we went and we learned about it, and I got to see just how this program works and the development. They told me about the development that it takes over the several years, and I really liked what I saw. It's a lot different than traditional school, but the things I saw made me really want to get on board and become a teacher with this program.
Hello, my name is Maya Moden. I decided to enroll in Driven because we have an option to get one-on-one connection with the teacher, and we're also able to get ahead of others if we want.
The thing I enjoy most about being a Driven student is being able to work at my own pace. Currently, I'm almost done with my history. I should be done by that by the time spring break comes.
Mr. Clayton asked me, would I step in? And I said, of course, because I was really interested in the program.
What attributes of the program do you most appreciate?
The attributes I most appreciate, first would be the flexibility in work. So you all have the opportunity to work at your own pace. A quick pace is what I recommend. And if you mess up on a test or quiz or lessons, we have an opportunity to go back and fix it. Another attribute I appreciate is the mentor part of it. So being able to talk with students and really get to know them.
What do you enjoy most about being in the Driven program?
The thing I enjoy the most is being able to work ahead, and if I need to ask a teacher for help, I do.
If you could make any changes to the program, what would it be?
The one change I would make is to have more hands-on projects.
Hey, Ms. Schlick.
Hey, Kamar.
I'm here to ask you questions about the Driven program. How is it that you became a tutor for Driven?
Well, I was working at various other Pulaski County schools last year. And when the position came available, one of the teachers at Robinson High School told me about the opportunity, and she said, well, I think you should apply for it and be something that you would be good at. So I applied for the position, spoke with Ms. Johnson about it once we interviewed, and she gave me a little bit more details about the program. I let her and Mr. Clayton know that I was highly interested in it.
The thing I enjoy most about being a Driven student or being a Driven is because I can work at my own pace, I get work done easier, and it's more quieter in the classes for me. If I can make any changes into the program, I will, I guess, better teaching.
I'm Mauricio, and I'm with Coach Nix, and she's going to be talking about Driven. So how is it that you became an inaugural teacher for Driven?
I was actually asked to join the program by Mr. Clayton. He had explained to me what the program was, and I was excited about it, and so I said yes.
Okay. What attributes of the program do you most appreciate?
The things I most appreciate about the program is the fact that students get to take ownership of their education. They are taking ownership of their curriculum. It is self-paced.
What I enjoy most about being a Driven student is the mentor meetings, because my mentor gives me tips on how I can finish my course early, and he gives me a weekly planner to do lessons where I can stay on track or get ahead.
The attributes I most appreciate are the flexibility of all the assignments, that you can always go back and do better if you decide to do so. I like that students are able to go at their own pace, and if a student is motivated enough, they can get a lot of things done when otherwise they would be held back in a traditional class.
Oh, well, I feel that my role dealing with students is very important. I feel like once you provide students with structure and give them a foundation, and another thing is getting to know them on the level of understanding where they're currently at, you can bridge the gap and build relationships with them, and it makes teaching them easier.
Well, I've always been interested in education, giving back to the kids. When I was in college, I used to be a tutor mentor for the UBMS mentor program there. So I just saw that there was a lot of the same similarities with the job description. And I applied for it, had my interview with Mr. Clayton. He saw me as a good fit, and I'm here.
Changes, I would say we could take more field trips, like for math, social studies, science. Because some students, including myself, learn better by doing hands-on activities. And I could say we can have an overflow schedule where some teachers or staff members can come into classrooms and help the students when the teacher or the tutor is occupied.
What challenges have you faced in your role?
One of the biggest challenges is not having room or space to work with students. A lot of times the students will come into, you know, one of the four driven classrooms and they need assistance from the tutor, but the teacher may be teaching at that time. So I would say, again, not being able to have just a small room to go and provide that one-to-one assistance to. Another thing was, in the beginning, I think students, you know, they didn't really know me and they didn't know how to respond. So being able to get them to know that if they needed help, to come find me or, you know, one of the other tutors to get their work done. But I think that, you know, once we've transitioned to the second semester, you know, there's been a lot more students coming in needing help.
Do you think that the future for the program will hold positive results for the students?
I definitely do. With this being a new program and students not really having clear expectations, you know, of what is expected of them, they kind of, you know, was like, okay, is this like a traditional setting or, you know, what exactly do you want me to do? So with them knowing and getting off to a better start the second semester, I can see a lot of students entering the program and the students that are currently in the program, you know, working ahead and utilizing it for the intent that it was designed for.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Some big obstacles we've had to overcome would be just that, you know, personally in my class, since everybody's going at their own pace, I might have 15 students at 15 different places. So if I'm trying to help them, I'd have to switch from one subject to another to another, from one topic to another to another, and just got to be prepared to come in and talk about wherever, anything, wherever they might be. But it is an obstacle, but it's a good thing because a lot of them are working hard and getting ahead.
Do you foresee this program being successful in the future?
I do, because from what I saw out at the school in Salt Lake, they said the first year is always going to be rough, but it gets better and better and better. And the reason it gets better is that when we start the next year, students come back already knowing what they're doing. There's not that confusion that happened at the beginning of our first year. And they say that's a consistency among every school that tries to do this. But I do think that starting when we start up again next year, everybody's going to come back knowing what they're doing. The new students will be surrounded by, you know, returning students who know what they're doing. There's going to be overall less confusion, and I do believe it's going to be more successful because of it.
What will it take for this program to be a success?
It cannot be a success without student buy-in. The students need to believe that they can do it, and the more they work at it, the more that they are trying, then they'll start seeing that they could actually be good at it when they put in the effort. Without that, though, when students just sit around not doing anything and complain that there's work to be done, nothing can be successful that way. That was a big problem in any school, traditional or driven. if students aren't motivated and aren't invested in it, involved in it, it can't be successful. So the main thing it would take for this to be successful is student buy-in.
What obstacles have you had to overcome in order to be successful in education?
Okay. Obstacles. So with anything new, there are going to be obstacles because we're figuring it out as we go along. I think the primary obstacle would be dealing with space, because we don't have enough space to move around like we want to offer the students the flexibility that we imagined in the beginning. So space is one obstacle. Another obstacle would probably be just getting everything completed, because as a teacher, we have a lot of things that we need to do, and it's difficult finding the time in the day to get it done.
Do you foresee this program being successful in the future?
Absolutely. I do foresee it being successful. I feel like it is catered to particular students for them to be successful. Students who know that they would like to get ahead and they know that they're self-motivated to get their work done. So being in charge of their education, so that opens a whole nother door for those students who are interested, and I can definitely see it growing.
What will it take for this program to be a success?
It will take support from teachers, from parents, administration, district office, all the levels up and up. We're gonna need their support to make this a success. And if we get that support, then we'll be able to try new things. We've taken a look at programs in different parts of the country, and also programs within the state who are doing similar things. So if we can keep in contact with them, collaborate with them, see what they're doing, then hopefully we'll be a success also.
Thank you. That's all we have today.
Thank you.
The things I most appreciate about the program are the fact that students have ownership of their curriculum. It's in their hands to pace through. I appreciate the fact that they can go as fast as they want to. I don't hold them back.
Right. What obstacles have you had to overcome in order to be successful in the instruction?
Obstacles, I've been doing something for one way for over a decade. So the obstacles I have had to overcome is letting go of control. For over a decade, I was the one that always, you know, made sure this was done in class every day, this was done in class every day. So I've had to kind of reflect on myself and let go of the reins and let students lead themselves. And to have an actual student-centered classroom, it's all about the students, where they're at, and meeting them where they're at. That's hard for me because I'm so used to, you know, this day happens here. So I've got, you know, every student has a individualized plan. So that's been something that I've had to overcome, is more of a reflection on myself and learning new management strategies for having to manage new management strategies to having to get every student accounted for and making sure that they are progressing properly.
Do you foresee this program being successful in the future?
I believe this program will be successful in the future. I believe that we do have the student body that wants to be in charge of their education. I think that once we've given students the chance to, once they've been able to see that they are able to progress as fast as they would like to, earning those high school credits and opening them up for either early graduation or possibly opening them up for different programs that we offer here at Mills, such as our AP program. That would be fantastic, or concurrent credit courses to earn college credit. I think it's going to be great.
What will it take for this program to be a success?
I think for this program to be a success is to be able to brand the program and actually have our students be the ambassadors of our program, have our students be the ones that are showing success in the program. We're being able to progress at a faster rate than their counterparts in traditional classrooms. For this program to be a continued success, we're gonna have to have students who are, pardon the pun, but driven to finish their high school credits.
All right, thank you.
I think the students see me as, you know, still young, still easy to get along with, not hard going, not, you know, easy to come to talk to or whatnot. So I feel like my relationship in that aspect with the students allows me to kind of engage where I need to be as far as their education. So, you know, a lot of students won't let you open up. They won't, you know, open up if you're not somebody that they can relate to. So I think I have a relatable qualities about me that helps me engage with the students. Some of the challenges I face is just trying to get the majority of the students on board with the intentions of the program. The intentions of the program are for the students to be able to advance in classes and earn potential college credits. And I think some of them right now just see it as like, you know, right now just some time to kind of like have leisure and not work. But that's my hardest challenge, is getting the kids to understand what type of program they're involved in. Anytime you do something the first time, it's the roughest time. So I think this is just a rough year. It's the first time it's being implemented into the school. It's gonna be a rough start, but I think with the dedication and the hard work that these kids are showing, they got a little behind the first semester, but I think that they're making tremendous improvement to do better going here on. So yes, I think that it's gonna be a positive result.
I really appreciate the flexibility of the program. Because of the flexibility, it allows students to do things multiple times if they need to, or take a little extra time so that we can start changing the mindset of students. Instead of being, you know, afraid to fail, students can feel, you know, more able to grow. Well, because I teach English, I've had to change and be extremely flexible with the type of things that I do. When it comes to discussion classes, for instance, it's been difficult to manage when the students are on different paces and, you know, in different places in the course. Working with students who have fallen behind has also been a challenge, but also a rewarding thing as well. And then working with students who are far ahead, making sure that they don't fall to the wayside and they still get some attention as well. Those things have been challenging.
Okay. Do you foresee this program being successful in the future?
Absolutely. I think that it can only get better from here. This year has been a big learning experience for a lot of us, for the other teachers here. And I think that we've got a really great idea of what needs to be fixed and improved upon.
What will it take for this program to be successful?
I think that efficacy on the part of teachers, staff, and students is what's going to make this a success.
I can't think of any changes that I will make. It's a really great program. I don't really have any problems with it.